Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBMI RPG sample video. On many occasions when we retrieve information from one or several tables using SQL, we don't need to obtain more than a limited number of rows, perhaps because I want to return them as a parameter or perhaps to display them in a subfile screen or maybe because we cannot store more than X number of elements in our data structure. Today I'd like to show you how to limit the number of rows we get using a select and from which row we want to get the information. For this, we're going to use limit and offset. Let's go. Well, to start, we're going to create a simple table that we are going to fill with many records. Let me start using run SQL Scripts utility. I'm going to use a simple table like this one. Well, let me create the table. It is going to have three fields. Let me run all these statements. And now, as in other examples, as we don't have this table journalized by default in this system, I'm going to start to journalize it. Let me write the command. Okay, now let me go to VS Code. I have a prepared simple program that will fill the table with 10,000 records. This is a very simple program. Let me show this source. It is this one. As you can see, it is only using a loop and inserting 10,000 records into the file. Okay, so let me compile the program and let me run it. Of course, as the program is not going to show a screen, I can run it from inside the run SQL scripts utility in the same way as I use a command. So I can write call test 91 this way and I can run it. Okay, so I can see if all the records are inside the table. And as you can see, all the records are inside. Okay, perfect. Well, now imagine that we have a program where I need to read 10 rows from this table, but not from the row number 1. Imagine I need to read 10 rows, but from the row number 5000, for example. For doing this, I have write something like this. Limit 10, because I want only 10 rows. Offset 4999. Why this number? Because I want to retrieve from day number 5000. Okay, so if I want to retrieve from the first row, I have to write offset 0. Okay, as you can see, this way I'm getting just 10 rows, and the first row I'm getting is day number 5000. Okay, and I can do the same with the next elements. Imagine that I want to get the next elements. Well, I want to get from the number 5009, I'm getting the rest, the next 10 elements, as you see. Okay, so as you see, in this way we can obtain 10 rows from a query in which we can also decide from which row of the complete query we want to obtain the information. That is very cool. Of course, if I change the limit and offset numbers, I will get different results, but always from the same query. Okay, I can write here, for example, 25, and I will get 25 rows. Okay. Well, How can I use it? Okay, for using this, I'm going to make a simple program where I'm going to have a subprocedure where that will return, for example, 100 elements from the table from the position passed as parameter. Okay, let's start making the program. Let's go to the VS Code. Let's close it. And we are going to make a new program. Okay, let me write three. Let's start creating the main procedure. And now let's write our subprocedure. For example, the name is gonna be getData. I will call the subprocedure in the, from the main procedure later, okay? Okay, the subprocedure will have as parameters the offset that is gonna have this type. And will be from this will be from which row I want to get the data, okay? And a structure like this one. Okay, this structure is where I'm going to store the data, okay? Okay, and also I want to retrieve the actual number of elements I'm retrieving, okay? Well, let me declare this structure here as a template. T. For example, okay. Well, what I need to do is this. Of course, all is in SQL. Let me declare a cursor. From okay, limit 100 because I want to retrieve 100 rows every time. Okay, offset. Okay. Let me open the cursor. And now what I'm going to do is to fetch the 100 elements, the 100 rows at the same time, okay? For max rows into products. Okay, max rows, I have to declare it. Okay, and I want to know how many elements, how many rows we have actually retrieved. Okay, and I think it is all done. Oh, it's driven. And let's return this the content of this variable. Okay, so I think it is all done. Okay, and now what I'm gonna do is to call this subprocedure. Let me first of all, I have to declare this structure. This is going to be an automatic structure. Also, I will need this number, because number is going to be the number of elements retrieved. Okay. This way, I will get 100 elements from the offset number 0, that is the same as saying from the first row into products. Okay, after that I can do this. It's equal to number. Why I do this? Because this structure is an auto structure, and I want to keep the data inside, but setting the number of elements of the structure to the correct number of elements retrieved. Okay. In this case, I will get 100 elements. But if I do something like this, I will not get 100 elements. Okay. I will get, in this case, just three elements. Three rows, okay? Well, for example, we can write okay, and I think it is all done. Let me compile the program. Okay, the first. And okay, now let's go to the green screen and let's check how it works. Okay, let's start a debug session as always. Now let me stop it here and let's run the program. Okay, the first thing I'm gonna do is to get 100 elements, 100 rows from the table, but from the row number 1, okay, inside the products structure. Okay, so let's go inside the subprocedure. The subprocedure, what I'm doing now is opening the cursor, and now I'm going to fetch the elements inside the products structure. Let me see the content of products. And as you can see, all the elements are inside, from 1 to 100. Okay. Now this way I'm getting the actual number of elements retrieved. That is 100. And I'm closing the cursor. I'm returning the retrieved elements. I'm setting here the number of elements of the structure to 100, and I'm sending to the job log this message that I can see this way: 100 elements retrieved. Okay, so it is working fine. What is gonna happen if I run the same sub procedure? If I send this as a parameter. Okay, let's see. Now I'm opening again the cursor. I'm fetching the data, and what I'm getting inside products is this. Okay? Well, you only have to see the first three elements. Okay? Why? Because I have not initialized the product's structure. But the number of elements retrieved are 3. Okay? So I only have to see the three first elements. I'm setting the number of the structure to 3, and I'm writing 3 elements retrieved in my job log. Okay? So it works fine. So as you've seen, this is a fantastic option to obtain the information we want, but in pieces. Many times we don't need to obtain it all, or we cannot due to the large amount of data that our queries return to us. Of course, this can be used for many things, as in the example, or to fill a subfile, etc. I hope it has been very useful to you. Click like if so. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel to receive new videos, and as always, thanks for watching.